So you're serious about learning hacking? Let me tell you up front, it's not about shortcuts or flashy tools. It's about persistence and building a strong foundation. I've walked this path and I know what works and what doesn't, so let me be your guide. I'll share the exact steps I took, the mistakes I made, and the resources that helped me get better. First, let's talk about networking. This was my starting point, and honestly, it should be yours too. When I began, I barely knew what an IP address was. I started with YouTube. Network Chuck has great beginner-friendly videos. But watching wasn't enough. I downloaded Cisco Packet Tracer and started messing around. I'd simulate small networks, connect devices, and try to understand how data flowed between them. If you're feeling ambitious, try a platform like TryHackMe. They have a whole module on networking that's hands-on and beginner-friendly. Once I got the basics down, I jumped into Wireshark. This tool is a game-changer. I'd open it, capture my own network traffic, and just look. I'd open websites, download files, and watch how packets moved. It was fascinating to see how my actions translated into data. If you're new to it, look up Chris Greer on YouTube. His Wireshark tutorials break it down step by step. Then came Linux. Look, I know Linux can feel intimidating at first. It did for me too, but you don't need to master it overnight. I started with Ubuntu before moving to Kali Linux, and I recommend doing the same. Ubuntu is beginner-friendly, and you can install it alongside your current operating system or use it in a virtual machine. I'd spend hours in the terminal learning simple commands like ls, cd, and chmod. There's a free resource called Over the Wire Bandit that's perfect for this. It's a CTF capture the flag game designed to teach you Linux commands. Once I was comfortable with Linux, I started experimenting with tools. Nmap was the first tool I learned, and it opened my eyes. I remember scanning my own network and being shocked at how much information it revealed. Open ports, operating systems, services. The Nmap documentation is fantastic and free, so don't skip it. Another tool that helped me early on was Burp Suite. I didn't dive into everything it could do right away, but I used it to understand how web applications worked, how requests were made, and how vulnerabilities could be exploited. Programming came next. Let me be real with you, I'm not a coding prodigy, and you don't have to be either. But knowing the basics makes a world of difference. I started with Python because it's beginner-friendly and widely used in hacking. The first thing I built was a simple script to automate Nmap scans. Then I moved on to writing scripts to parse data or interact with APIs. If you're not sure where to start, Codecademy and FreeCodeCamp are excellent for Python basics. Once you've got the hang of Python, explore bash scripting. It's invaluable for automating tasks on Linux. As I got more confident, I needed a safe space to practice. Building my own lab was a game changer. I used VirtualBox to set up a small network of virtual machines. One of them ran Metasploitable, a purposely vulnerable machine designed for hacking practice. The other was a standard Linux server. I'd use tools like Nmap, Hydra, and Metasploit to test different attack methods. If you're looking for guided practice, Hack the Box and TryHackMe are fantastic. TryHackMe especially holds your hand when you're starting out, while Hack the Box is better when you're ready to dive into the deep end. Now let me be honest, this journey isn't always smooth. I've spent hours staring at error messages, googling obscure problems, and feeling like I wasn't making progress. That's normal. Hacking is a skill, and like any skill, it takes time. What kept me going was community. Find people who share your interests. Reddit/netsec and Discord servers for ethical hacking are full of like-minded folks who can help you when you're stuck. One last thing, don't just stop at tools and techniques. The hacking mindset is just as important. Whenever you encounter a system, ask yourself, what could go wrong here? How could someone misuse this? It's this curiosity, this constant questioning, that will set you apart. And remember, hacking is about learning, not destruction. Stay ethical, respect boundaries, and focus on building something positive. But I also know how confusing and overwhelming this can feel when you're starting out. There's so much to learn, and it's easy to get lost or waste time on the wrong things. That's exactly why I created Cyberflow's Academy. It's a one-stop platform where I've broken down everything you need to know into step-by-step guides and hands-on labs. Want to master networking? We've got detailed lessons and practical challenges. Need to get comfortable with Linux? There's a whole section on command line basics and advanced tools. The best part? You don't have to figure this out alone. Cyberflow's Academy is all about community. You'll get access to forums and a network of learners who are just as excited about hacking as you are. Whether you're just starting out or looking to level up, this is the kind of support I wish I had when I was learning. So, if you're ready to stop guessing and start making real progress, join us at Cyberflow's Academy. It's your shortcut to learning the right way without the overwhelm. Let's build your skills and get you hacking like a pro in no time.